अस्सलाम वालेकुम। एक भाई ने अपनी तीनों बहनों को अपने वालिद फैज बख्श मरहूम की हिस्सा विरासत से बिल्कुल महरूम कर दिया गया है मौजा आदम एंड तहसील जिला लोधरा में, तो उसका जो सिविल कोर्ट में दरमियानी हुक्म लिखा जाता है मैं आज आपको मुकम्मल पढ़कर सुनाऊंगा कि उस हुक्म में क्या तफसीलात लिखी होती है। सरदारी माई वर्सेस प्रोविंस ऑफ पंजाब ETC 29 सितंबर 2022 प्रेजेंट लार्नेट काउंसिल फॉर द पार्टीज लार्नेट ADA ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ डिफेंडेंट नंबर 124 थ्रू दिस ऑर्डर आई प्रपोजेड टू डिसाइड एन एप्लीकेशन अंडर ऑर्डर 39 रूल 1 एंड 2 CPC फिल्ड बाय द पटिशनर प्लेंटिव टू प्रिसाइज fact necessary for the disposal of application or as under that the plaintiff claimed the Faiz Bakhsh son of Sardar Mohammad was dead on 20 February 2010 and that inheritance mutation of deceased falls upon the legal shares and that attested mutation on the basis of oral tamleek bearing number 4389 dated 30 June 2006 mutation number 4394 dated 10 July 2006 mutation number 4705 dated 20 August 2007 and inheritance mutation number 285 dated 8 July 1998 and in all mutations the plaintiff has been shows in pedigreeable but in village the plaintiff has been deprived from her share of inheritance of Faiz Bakhsh deceased and that the plaintiff has received inheritance mutation in the 4 different villages but in village Adamwan she has been deprived from her lawful share so that instant suit along application for grant of temporary injunction number 3 The defendant's respondent was summoned through journal process. Defendant number 124 put their appearance before the court and opted to contest the suit by filling written statement and written reply inter alia on the following grounds that the plaintiff has got no cause of action and Lucas Standy to file the suit against the answering defendants and mutations were effected in accordance with law that this court has no jurisdiction to entertain this suit and prayed for dismissal of the suit as well as application defendant number 5, 6, 7, 14, 15 submitted that the plaintiff has no cause of action and Lucas Standy to file the instant suit against the answering defendants. The plaintiff is stopped by her words and conduct to file this suit. The plaintiff has not come to the court with clean hand and also prayed for dismissal of the suit as well as application. Number 4 argument here. Number 5 learned counsel for the respondent argued that the petitioner earlier filed a civil suit which was dismissed as a withdrawal and the present suit has been filed without permission of the court. Therefore, the suit is not maintainable and prayed for dismissal of the suit as well as application. Number 6. Conversely, learned counsel for the petitioner argued that the earlier filed suit was dismissed as withdraw with the permission to file fresh, which of which is available with the plaint, and that the petitioner earlier filed an application before the assistant commissioner Lodhra, who was pleaded to declare that the petitioner has a lawful right of inheritance and it is an old transaction, and the petitioner was advised to approach to the civil court. And order of the assistant commissioner Lodhra dated 14 December 2021 makes the case of the petitioner as a arguable and prayed for acceptance of the application. Number 4. I have gone through the record with able assistance of learned counsel for the parties and pursued that record. Number 5. From the contents of pleadings and record, it is observed that the Assistant Commissioner Lodhra void order dated 14 December 2021 has declared the petitioner as a legal heirs of deceased Fazbakhsh. This document makes the case of the petitioner plaintiff arguable one, and if the respondent alienated the property to the someone else, it may enlarge the lease, which is consequently cause inconvenience and irreparable loss to the petitioner. Therefore, I am of the view that all necessary ingredients for grant of temporary injunction co-existed in favor of the petitioner and against the respondents. Therefore, the application in hand deserved merits accepted accordingly. Number 6. Out of the divergent pleadings of the parties, following issue are hereby framed issues. Number 1. Whether the plaintiff is entitled to get decree for declaration as prayed for OPP. Number 2. Whether the plaintiff has not cause of action to file the instant suit OPD. Number 3. Whether the plaintiff is stopped by her words and conduct to file the instant suit OPD. Number 4. Whether the plaintiff has not come to the court with clean head OPD. Number 5. Whether the plaint of the suit be rejected under order 7 rule 11 CPC OPD. Number 6. Relief. Parties are directed to submit their list of witness along certificate of readiness to produce evidence within 7 days positively. Parties are also directed to certify the court regarding production of witness before learned trial judge. Parties are at liberty to file objection on issues framed till next date of hearing. Parties may also file and kind of miscellaneous application till next date of hearing. Note to come up on 7 October 2022. Announced 29 सितंबर 2022 शाहवार अमीन वागा सिविल जज फर्स्ट क्लास एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव जज लोधरा। इस ऑर्डर में जज साहब ने लिखा कि मुदैया का जो वालिद है फैज बख्श सन ऑफ सरदार मोहम्मद कासिम चन्नड़ 20 फरवरी 2010 को वफात पा चुका है और जो इंतकाल तमलीक जबानी हुए हैं 43/99, 43/94, 47/05 उस पर मुदैया सरदारी मई को शिजरा नसब में दुख्तर जहर किया गया है फैज बख्श मरहूम की। तो दूसरा इसमें जज साहब ने लिखा है कि असिस्टेंट कमिश्नर लोधरा ने भी यही लिखा है कि मुदैया सरदारी मई और सद्दू मई जोजा मोहम्मद अब्दुलरशीद दुख्तर फैज बख्श कास चन्नड़ जो है हिस्सा विरासत पाने की हकदार है। मुदैया सरदारी मई को अपने वालिद फैज बख्श मरहूम की हिस्सा विरासत से बिल्कुल महरूम कर दिया गया है मौजा आदावेंट सील जिला लोधरा में। आज मैंने आपको जो मुकम्मल पढ़कर सुनाया है ये त्रिवानी हुक्म है और इस दावा इस्तकरार हक का जो फैसला है 9 मई 2024 को लिखा गया है। नेक्स्ट वीडियो में आपको इस दावा इस्तकरार हक का फैसला सुनाया जाएगा। शुक्रिया।